On the show today, Cardi B begs for Nigerian citizenship. Davido debunks Ghana truth with baby mama. Kaffi and Kedoni engaged. And Tasha sacks manager. If you're there, welcome on board. Your host, Sydney Shocker, is standing by.
My name is still Sydney Shocker. How you doing? Still enjoying the chicken and rice and waxing or waxing the euphoria of the new year? It's all good. But hey, let's take a break from all the goodies, man, and check out all that's been trending all week long. Welcome on board. Welcome to Social Trend. So, as you are still waxing in the euphoria of the new year, 2020, let's take our time and check out all the top trends, man. Top 20 stories that we brought to you last year, 2019. Let's go fish them out.
So I want you to help me out here. Give me three characteristics of what a Big Brother winner should have.
Okay. Calm down, though. Tasha.
That's not very smart. I didn't say name, I said characteristics.
And as we bask on the euphoria of this year 2020, new year, let's take our minds back to last year and check out among those trends, which amongst them actually blew our minds, like trended most. Yeah! Was it Sex for Greats? Haha! Or Burna Boy nominated for the Grammys? Or was it R. Kelly being arrested and docked in court? Or Davido proposing to Chioma, the love of his life? Or maybe Nairo Mali being arrested, locked up behind bars for a long time, and the case dragging in court? Or being a Messi of Big Brother Niger when she won the show, being the first Nigerian woman to ever do so? Or of late, Angela Okore being attacked while coming from an event? Or maybe Cardi B storming Niger and blowing the entire country to flames? Not forgetting as well, Two-Face Idibia and Blackface battling and later reconciling before the end of last year. Or maybe Wizkid tweeting to get married this year, 2020, and rebrand by changing his name. Which among these trends? Because all of these events, happenings, they trended like crazy last year. So which amongst them will you say trended most to you and blew your mind, like made you go, oh my god, OMG, I want to know. So hit me up right here on the show. You can see my Twitter handle on the screen at IYSydney. That's my Twitter handle. Or you can tweet at us via our platform's Twitter handle at ITVRadioNG. Any you want to use, you're free. So grab your phones and get it on. Let me know which trended most. You never know, you might be winning something from me at the end of the day. So just keep those fingers working. Let it work. Let it work.
Security guy, this guy come up for my front. He can go to the back though. You can't stay in the front. The front is simply for my normal diehard brand world back. Everyone that's been working with me. Everyone that understands what the fuck I did this for. Everyone that's seen my sorrow, my sweat, my blood, my tears. That I put it to this music.
Absolutely, those were the trends, man. From Burna Boy to Whiskey, Tasha, they were all training. These reports were crazy, man. For real, you know? They made you wonder why, how, when, where, what's happening. That's social media for you. That's the craze. And we have the show right here every Thursday and Sundays, man. Social Trend. Presented by Moa, your boy. You know the drill. Still on trends, man. Let's go check out all the trends that's happened this period.
Ever since she left Nigeria, Cardi B has never hidden her love for the country. She reps the country more than you and I because she screams every day, every now and then, on how she loves Nigeria.
I like this country a lot. Let me tell you something. You wanna know why I like this country? Because you find everything that you're really looking for in this country. Like, let's say this country have like tourism. Like if you wanna like, you know, go to beaches and relax with your couple, with your husband, with your wife, they have that. If you're looking for culture, if you want to see how people are living, how people make a living, you have that. Over here, it reminds me of the Caribbean island with a touch of New York, because everybody is busy. Everybody's busy. Everybody's going to a place. Like, the streets are always crowded. And
well, going by the recent happenings between her country, the U.S., Iraq, and Iran, Cardi B posted on her Instagram page, stating why she really wants to be a Nigerian citizen ASAP. She said, "Nah, these memes are crazy, but they ain't no jokes, especially being from New York. It is sad. This man is putting American lives in danger. Dumbest move ever done to date. I'm filing for Nigerian citizenship ASAP." Believe me, you, Cardi B seen not getting enough of the Nigerian vibe. Will you blame her? When they come here, we always show them those places they love to see and take them to those areas they love to be. I hope when she comes around, somebody should sneak her to the Mushins, Maracals, Ajingule, and what have you. Famous American musician Robert Rick Mill Williams, who is well known as Meek Mills, has indicated his intention of moving over to Africa. The development is following the recent attack by the US on Iran, which claimed the life of a high top-ranking Iranian army chief. The rapper made the declaration after blasting President Donald Trump on Twitter. In his view, Donald Trump is endangering the lives of innocent Americans with his greedy and selfish moves. However, he didn't reveal which African country he will be going to. Unlike Cardi B, an American female rapper who made the intentions of filing for a Nigerian citizenship known.
What did you say?
I said I want to talk to my daddy.
Okay, I'll send this to him. What do you want to tell him?
I want to say I love you.
Aww.
Davido has begged bloggers and media practitioners to please mind what they publish about his wife-to-be, Chioma. According to Davido, such reports hurts her family. Hurts them really bad and hurts them too because they are his in-laws-to-be. Oh yeah. This against the backdrop, a video having Davido and his baby mama, Sophia Momodu, with their only daughter, Imane, went viral on social media before New Year's Day with the report he was taking them out for a Ghana treat. Mind you, Davido was having an event in Ghana that very day. Well, according to Davido, he said, and I quote, "I never flew anyone out for a treat in Ghana. Rather, they were having their own engagement. And due to the inadequate ticket purchased at the airport, and I was going to Ghana myself for my own event, I decided to help them. Hence, we boarded my private jet. On getting to Ghana, we went our separate ways. Please, stop publishing such hurtful reports about me. It hurts Chioma's family and hurts me too." Davido, what a lover boy, yeah? Well, contrary to Davido's denial flying his baby mama and daughter Imade to Ghana during the Yuletide, the lady in question, Sophia Momodu, has come out to set the record straight, stating it wasn't an airlift, but a trip. And moreover, she never asked for it anyway. The very furious lady promised bringing down and burning the house if care wasn't taken by revealing vital information about Davido people didn't know. In her words, "I'ma burn this ish down," she posted on her Instagram page days ago.
So what about you that did not sign for? You feel
we
you deserve?
We deserve.
Period. Rachel, do you deserve the truth?
Yes.
Mo, do you deserve the truth?
Yes.
Yes.
Of course.
Okay. Yalla. Okay, yalla, yalla.
What's that meme that was raining one time, like "stop the lies" or something? I think that's what I would name the vlog. Stop the lying. No. Why you lying? Why you lying? Do you know every time I hear that I miss Olu, because that was what reminds me of Olu. Oh my god. Stop lying.
Davido and Sophia Momodu were once an item in 2015 and a father gave birth to their only child, Imade Adeleke. Nigerian foremost comedian Basket Mouth tweeted against social media sensation and entertainer Speed Darlington running for presidency come 2023. According to Basket Mouth, the singer doesn't have what it takes to become the president of Nigeria and wonders how he would run the country if actually elected.
Meet me around that guy. Seven, I think I even bros, man, since morning, we never chop. And that's 7 a.m. I think you didn't talk like the afternoon, don't reach. Say, bros, man, we don't wake up since. come like that 2 days, never seen my comic talent. Sir, 2 days for Nigeria, no woman.
No woman, yeah, 2 days, man. You don't bring money, come outside. Same man.
It's the
same. Speak, I didn't want to run for president.
Move on, move on for him, move on for him.
Who shall president be that? When they do like this.
Yeah, vote for him.
So now when he come, imagine say he can't win.
Speed Darlington, Igbo by Tribe, is a Nigerian social media sensation who, for the very first time in 10 years, visited Nigeria, where he performed at numerous concerts and made his intention known, running for president come 2023.
Oh yeah, cool down, cool down. I love you too, baby. Fala bale. Oh yeah, I calm down, calm down.
Wizkid was full of life and high spirits as he tweeted, promising to walk down the aisle this year 2020 and change his name from Wizkid to, well, only he knows for the now. Never did we expect he would become so furious after shutting down his Star Boy Fest in Lagos on the 27th of December 2019, a sold-out show. Over the report about a fan of his who attended the concert, shot and killed in cold blood while returning back home from the concert. According to reports, the police, who considered him a Yahoo boy while returning back from the show, shot at him for refusing to part with his hard-earned funds. To this, Wizkid tweeted, "This is so mean. Nigerian police, why? Why kill my fan? I feel very down right now. Nigerian police, protect us, not kill us. I am so sorry, guys. I am so broken right now." Like we all know, this has been the case between the Nigerian police and the timid Nigerian youths who, for their love of the pop culture lifestyle, are quickly tagged Yahoo boys by the police, molested, arrested, exploited, and most of the times killed for no reason. Though it was confirmed through old school rapper Rugged Man that the police in question, who carried out the very gruesome act, has been arrested, the question is, will justice be served knowing the police for what they are? Fingers crossed. Yes, I said yes, was the caption Kaffi of 2019 Big Brother Niger Pepper Dem Show used to waking everyone up on Boxing Day while celebrating the Christmas. The UK police officer couldn't hide her joy as she disturbed the social media space with pictures and videos of their vacation at Cape Verde and on how, like a thief in the night, her Big Brother house lover, Gadoni, proposed to her and she said yes. Like we all know, the romance between this duo began long ago at the Big Brother Niger Pepper Dem house, where barely a week into the show, Kaffi fell heads over heels in love with Gadoni that led to several sex romps on live TV. Though they denied, but we all know what we watched throughout the season. So this has put an end to the doubt if they were actually in love or not while in the house. For Kaffi has said several times, though she didn't win the money, she won the man and the relationship while on the show. And Gadoni, as well, has always professed his undying love for Kaffi at every given chance. But can we forget this now dubbed epic reaction when Gadoni screamed yes while being evicted from the show?
Gadoni, you have have been evicted from the Big Brother house.
To date, it still beats us hello what he was so excited about while being evicted from the house. Guess you and I will never know until finally he decides to reveal why. All the same, congrats, lovebirds.
You can find me in the middle. I go die for the middle. Cause you do sweet time for me, do you know? You know, you know. Go to the middle, you know. You know, you know.
Trust me, it would have been sweet in the middle. Not a good time if what Davido narrowly escaped from the front of his house on Christmas Day actually happened. It would have rather been a very sad time. A very clear opposite of his album cover, A Good Time. Report has it, the multiple award-winning artist narrowly escaped being implicated in a free-for-all fight at the front of his house on Christmas Day as early as 4 a.m. in the morning over money he gave to the street urchins who always lay siege at the front of his house. And trust me, this blew up some pandemonium in the middle of the night as a young man was reported to have been stabbed in both eyes while dragging for his own share of the money. This we understood, true, Davido's Abiodun Awosika Lekki Lagos house in disarray as everyone was running helter-skelter just to avoid being implicated as well as bloodshed. As soon as Davido was alerted about the ongoing pandemonium in front of his house, a day he was to have his own show in Lagos, which at the end of the day was a sold-out show, Davido could be heard in panic screaming, "Call the police, oh! Call the police! I'm not involved, though. It is Christmas Day. I don't want anyone to involve me, oh! Call the police!" Poor Dave. It is a well-known fact, Davido, whenever he's around, usually does that money for these street urchins, who are always resident at the front of his gate. Why this became bloody this time around is still something no one can comprehend. And just in case you are wondering why no video of this on social media, we understand his boys who recorded it were given a stern warning not to share or upload the video on social media in order not to drag Davido into the mess. Price you pay for being the star that gives, I suppose.
Kilo come, I'm getting money, biggie money, so what's the fun? Ubi risky, body whiskey, get tipsy, but thought it got risky. Kilo come, I'm getting money, biggie money, so what's the fun? Ubi risky, body whiskey, get tipsy, but thought it got risky.
Ike,
sir.
Ike,
I really appreciate it.
Hey guy.
I'm a married man now.
Ike of the Big Brother Niger Pepper Dem show, parting ways with winner and love heart, Mercy, has been speculated all through social media late last week. Just had it, the both stopped following each other on Instagram, while pictures of Ike with Tatcha, both at her birthday and the car, just to mention a few, surfaced on social media, surprisingly. Rumor has it as well that the reason why this happened was because Ike got wind of Mercy sleeping with Cubana chief priest, the same dude she was having problem with some couple of months back in Owerri. Well, to this, the very soft-spoken, shy American Nigerian tweeted and said, "It is just a rumor. We are cool. My work schedule is the reason why you hardly see us together any longer." Are we believing this in a hurry? One thing I know for sure is social media always has a way of revealing the truth at the end of the day. So IK, we are watching. Then, a very sad one hit us, having to deal with a certain 400-level student by name Favor of the Lagos State University, Lasu, who went on holiday at her boyfriend's house, Owolabi Adeku, in Osun State, only to end up in the mother's pot as a human pepper soup, something we all know as a juju ritual kind of native soup. And the mother of the boy, Mrs. Adeku, was said to have eaten it with joy in order to be wealthy as she used to be way back in the day. According to reports, we understand the girl lied to her parents on getting home in Lagos that she was going to see a friend, and from there zoomed off to meet her boyfriend at Osun State, who requested she comes around so they can spend the Yuletide together, unknown to her that this was going to be her end. On getting to Osun State, according to the boy, Owolabi Adeku, he led her to a prophet's house, Prophet Philip, who spiked a drink before killing and using her for juju native pepper soup ritual for the lady, Mrs. Adeku. though in police custody, there are fears in some quarters that they might be released anytime soon, for they were heard boasting that they'll be out before anyone knows it. We just hope that doesn't happen. So, social media buffs, sharpen your data and let's ensure justice is served. Let's turn over to Lil Ketch's abode. Remember this epic fall while performing on stage late last year, 2019? Well, he says, it isn't a big deal, for all have fallen and risen up at one point in time or the other. Most essentially, it's been able to stand up and do you. You're right, bruv. How can we forget the very unsuccessful First Bank heist in Abuja a few days after Christmas, December 28th, which was on Saturday? According to the culprits, the bank's branch manager allegedly was the brain and mastermind behind the heist that went sour. The robbers were cycled in the bank for hours before apprehended by the security personnel, who exchanged firepower with the robbers. And Tasha finally did what everyone has been expecting her to do, or anticipating, sacked her manager, two bills. This happened during the Christmas period, where she confirmed the sack and they're going their separate ways, with a lengthy post that read, "I'm thanking my former management for their love and support, but moving on is imperative. No bad blood, we are good, we just went our separate ways." Was I the only one who knew this relationship wasn't going to stand the test of time? I doubt.
Trends, 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 my brother. Can we ever do without trends when it comes to social media? No way. And I tell you, 2020, I've got my eyes on you guys. I got my ears to the ground. I know it's going to rock again when it comes to trends, man, on our social media outlet. Don't forget, in a hurry, Social Trend hits you every Thursday on our satellite broadcast, GoTV 107, Star Times 130 at 4:30 p.m. Yeah. Then you have a repeat broadcast on our terrestrial channel, and that's channel 22 at 1:30 p.m. every Sundays. Don't ever miss, especially this year, 2020, because I've got a whole lot lined up for you. Talking about stuff lined up for you brings to mind what we call our top 5 trending videos. Are you ready? If you are, Desire, take us there.
Top 5 trending videos of the week. Top 5 trending videos of the week. Trending videos of the week. 5 trending videos of the week. Top 5 trending videos of the week. Top 5 trending videos of the week.
There you have it. Top 5 trending videos, man. Yeah, you know, back to back, y'all. Breaking trends and breaking dreams at the end of the day. Can we leave without dropping on you our goof of the week? No way.
Goof of the week. Goof of the week.
I'm Sydney. I'll catch you on the next one, man. Have yourself a wonderful year 2020. Ciao. I'm out of the house. Yeah.